GAT Shield Browsing allows admins to view all sites their users are browsing. Starting at the top, you can click on the Load More Data button to look further into the history of your user's browsing activity. These pie charts here show you the visits made to sites, the time spent on those sites, the number of visits by a user, and the time spent on sites by users. In this area, we can view what site URLs were recently visited, the time spent on that site, when the user opened or closed that site, and which user it was. As an admin, you can apply tags to sites. To add a tag, we need to click on the URL tagging section. Click on Add a Tag. In this example, I could tag youtube.com as video and learning. The results would then show on the browsing section. To see those tags in action, simply apply a filter and use the tag search. In this example, I will see if one of my OUs are visiting sites that are tagged as social. Now I can see the results. The charts will also represent the new information. I can also export the data as CSV if I want. You may notice that some sites only display their name rather than the entire URL. This is done by super admins in the URL mapping section. Here we can add a mapping. For example, youtube.com can be displayed as YouTube. To get an overall summary of the activity for a period of time, select Browsing Summary at the top of the screen in the Browsing section. Here you can select a range for the data. Our scope is currently set on domain. I can change that to a subdomain if I wish. The scope can also be changed to search for OUs, groups, users, and for educational domains, you'll have an option for courses, which will allow you to select your Google Classrooms. In this example, I'll look for the browsing activity for my marketing OU for the past 30 days. Here I can see which users spent the most time on sites, and what sites they spent that time on. You can also export any of these charts as PNG files. That concludes this GAT Shield how-to. Thanks for watching.